results coming out of the local government election.
Yeah, well, thanks. First of all, let me say we have four of the five candidates who contested here in San Fernando. One, Faith Combs, had to leave because she had a very long day, very long period of campaigning. But as you would see, all the four candidates that we have in the San Fernando City Corporation are very young. And so one of the significant things about the MSJ in this campaign is that a lot of our candidates were very young people who have come forward, who have stepped up to the plate and decided they want to make an intervention, want to make change in the country. And that says something, that sends a very powerful signal. And I want to congratulate all of our candidates. I've been in touch with most of them during the evening. And of course, our candidates have lost in terms of the vote count, but they have all said, as far as they're concerned, that the process of starting the change has taken place, because in places where we didn't have a single vote before, we now have people recognizing the MSJ as a political party and people prepared to vote for us. So that is a major step forward. And we are taking that as a positive coming out of this election experience. The fact that our candidates may not have won a seat is not, for us, the most important thing. We have moved in some cases from zero to 100, 200, as the case may be, and that is very important in terms of people coming out to vote for us. In the face of great odds of fighting the status quo of two parties that spend millions of dollars, that engaged in inducements, that have a culture of and a pattern of voting along lines of race and religion and geography and so on. And therefore, the process of challenging that status quo is not an easy one, but we are prepared to continue that process. And many of the candidates I spoke with tonight said that they're ready to go again, they're ready to start in a day or two after they get some rest, to go back in the communities and really take up the problems of people in the communities. Because the feedback that we were getting throughout the campaign is that people are fed up. And we don't think that that mood of people being fed up is going to change after tonight. In fact, it'll probably get more intense, because the election is not going to change the price of coffee, essentially, in terms of people's lives and the state of our communities.
So, Mr. Duda, you see this as a small victory for the MSJ?
Yes, we have taken a step forward. We were in many new areas of the country where we were never before. And we got traction. Many thousands of people now know more about the MSJ today than they knew some weeks ago, and that is positive too. And we have many young people coming in, and therefore the party itself has been energized by the presence of all these young people who want to make a difference in their communities and in the lives of people with whom they interact.
Mr. Abdullah, going into the general election 2020, do you think there's going to be more of a strategy going into this election with your candidates, with your members? Tell me what are your plans for 2020?
Well, our position prior to this election is that we were going to contest, or we are going to contest the general elections. We have not changed our position on that. And we will then obviously look at the numbers in different corporations and see what those numbers say to us. But also in terms of our most important task now is to consolidate what we have gained coming out of this election. Going back into the communities, our candidates have pledged to go back into the communities, engage the community, because we don't intend to be like the other parties, show up just for the campaign and then disappear and become ghost representatives. We intend to be the real representatives of the people on the ground, not only where we contested and campaigned, but in other areas of the country where we did not have a candidate. We intend to continue working with people, listening to people, and struggling with them for a better life for themselves and their families and for their communities. And we expand, therefore, the movement for social justice and build it into a strong movement, which is what I said repeatedly during the campaign. I said that what we are doing is building a powerful movement for change in the country, and that is not an overnight process.
Mr. Abdullah, if you have one message for persons viewing this out there, especially the youth, what will you tell them?
Interestingly, it was a deputy political leader who said this to some of the polling agents who were there before they left. That is that many of the persons who voted in this local government elections were older persons. In other words, a lot of the younger people did not come out to vote. And therefore, the young people are quite clearly disenchanted, disillusioned, not interested. What I'm saying to them is that they have to recognize that they have power. And that they therefore need to come together and demonstrate that power in a political way and see that through a process of political activism, as I did, for example, when I was young, and as these young candidates, Sharon Skeet, Anderson Scott, O.C. Leonard, and Aaron Alexander have done as young people. They came out and said, we can have power as young people once we organize, unite, and are conscious, and have a vision for going forward. And that's what the MSA is offering.
There you have it, folks.